We're collecting 3,000 environmental or fecal samples from waterfowl from across the state. Carlos Avery is one of those sites that's a control. In other words, it's a place with waterfowl but doesn't have an infected turkey barn nearby. So we're trying to collect 1,500 samples from around infected facilities and 1,500 samples from major units or around major units, WMAs, to try and compare, basically have a control. So staff have been out at Carlos. They put foam platforms out, put some bait on them to try and get ducks to start using the platforms and then leave droppings. So then every day the staff go and they look for those duck droppings and they take a swab from each dropping and they put three swabs into a container and that gets mailed to USDA in Fort Collins for avian influenza testing. When it gets to the lab, they're looking for one of 144 AI viruses that waterfowl carries. If it comes back positive, they test it further to see if it's H5 or H7, which are the two versions that can be highly pathogenic. It certainly has vast economic costs associated with it in the domestic poultry industry. And so we want to contribute to that knowledge base and do what we can to identify, what might be the source or the reservoir. The next big step in surveillance that we still have to work out is waterfowl banding. We banned 3,000 to 4,000 ducks across the state in late July through early September. So we'll actually be doing avian influenza surveillance with wild birds in hand this summer. We are in it with USDA Wildlife Services. They're great partners on the work that we do. They're instrumental in helping facilitate our sampling. They're getting all the environmental samples in the Fort Collins lab and they're testing those samples for free. The other relationship we have is with USGS, United States Geological Survey. We're at the National Wildlife Health Center lab in Madison, Wisconsin. For a couple of weeks, it was pretty big. When we were really getting a lot of environmental samples in multiple places, we probably had about 30 to 35 staff working on it. It's definitely been a drop what you're doing and help, and once again, our staff step up and they do that. So it's the caliber of the folks that work for this outfit are really unparalleled, I think.